The first step to understanding how to control cancer costs is to truly understand where we're spending money and why. There's three key findings. Is that first, and this is somewhat surprising, but if you look at per patient per year spending on actively cancer-treated patients from 2004 to 2014, and compare that to the non-cancer treatment population or the total population itself, there really hasn't been a higher rate of increase in the rate of spending over that 10-year period of time. That was somewhat surprising to us. Now, there's no doubt that oncology patients are more expensive, but the rate of spending increase has not been any higher than other medical populations, despite the fact that oncology has been such an innovative area. The other issue that we learned was that the migration of private practices to hospital outpatient has been a major cost driver. There's been a substantial shift to the hospital over the past 10 years. If we modeled the data and looked at 2014, if that shift had never occurred, and if we had kept the mix of physician office to hospital outpatient chemotherapy treatments the same, Medicare would have saved $2 billion just in 2014 alone.